Hello and welcome to the University of Ottawa Heart Institute Patient and Family Education Session on Coronary Artery Disease. My name is Bonnie Quinlan. I'm an advanced practice nurse in cardiology here. This session will complement the booklet that you have been given called Coronary Artery Disease, A Guide for Patients and Families. To get the most from the information we have provided you, please review your booklet frequently over the next few weeks. Use it as an ongoing resource in the future as necessary. If you turn to the inside cover off your booklet, you will see a list of details that we've suggested that you have prior to leaving the Heart Institute. Please ensure that you have ticked off all of the boxes prior to leaving the Heart Institute to ensure that you have all the information that you need when you go home. This session is divided up into different topics: the development of coronary artery disease, heart attack and angina, risk factors for the development of coronary artery disease, the healing process after heart attack, nutrition, physical activity, medications, and stress, depression, and anxiety. We hope you find this information helpful and informative. Coronary artery disease develops when cholesterol and other substances build up within the walls of the artery and eventually turn into a hard plaque. This process can start actually at a very early age and is caused by a combination of genetic and lifestyle factors, which we call risk factors. Certain risk factors, such as high cholesterol, high blood pressure, smoking, and uncontrolled diabetes, can cause this process to happen very quickly within the coronary arteries. We have divided up the risk factors for the development of coronary artery disease into different categories. There are a few risk factors which we have no control over, such as our age, our sex, and having a family history of coronary artery disease. These are things that you have no control over and no ability to change, just something to be aware of. If you turn to page 13 of your coronary artery disease booklet, you will find a table indicating modifiable risk factors for heart disease. These are risk factors that must be controlled or changed in order to help keep your arteries free of cholesterol and plaque buildup in the future. The column that's titled Target Goals indicates where specifically your values, such as your blood pressure, your cholesterol, your blood sugar level, your activity level, your level of stress and depression, need to be. For example, under the cholesterol risk factor, if you move across to the target goal column, you will see that your LDL, or your bad cholesterol, needs to be under 2, your cholesterol ratio less than 4, and triglyceride level below 1.7. A combination of good heart-healthy nutrition and cholesterol medication will help keep your levels within this target range. We've also given you parameters for your blood pressure. For example, if you are not diabetic or have any kidney problems, your blood pressure should be less than 140 over 90 in your doctor's office and less than 135 over 85 if you're taking it at home. If you do have diabetes or kidney disease, it should be less than 130 over 80 in your doctor's office and less than 125 over 75 at home. Again, a combination of lifestyle and medication will help to keep your blood pressure within this safe range. We encourage you to refer to this table frequently in the future and even bring it with you to your medical appointments, allowing you to compare your values with the target goals that are listed within this middle column. Angina, or heart pain as it is often referred to, is caused by a lack of oxygen-rich blood to the heart, usually a result of significant plaque buildup within the artery restricting blood flow. Angina typically comes on with activity and is usually relieved with rest. Everyone can experience angina pain quite differently. Some of our patients complain of an indigestion-like feeling, chest burning or pressure, pain or numbness in one or both arms, back pain, or sometimes just even shortness of breath. What sort of symptoms were you having prior to your admission to the Heart Institute? If those type of symptoms were to happen again ever in the future, would you recognize these as possibly being your angina discomfort? By comparison, a heart attack is caused by a complete blockage of blood flow to the heart muscle. If the heart does not get enough oxygen for 20 minutes or more, some degree of permanent heart damage will occur. In most cases, what has happened is that the plaque that has built up inside the artery over years and years and years cracks. When the plaque cracks, a blood clot will form. If the artery has narrowed, it is possible then for this blood clot to lodge itself in the narrowing, causing a complete blockage of blood flow. There are several ways in which your doctor can determine the size of your heart attack or how much damage was done. The tests such as an echocardiogram, nuclear scans, or a ventriculogram will provide your doctor with this information. The majority of people who have heart attacks in 2011 are able to return to their normal activities, usually within a range of 1 to 3 months' time. The reason that people return to their own normal lifestyle within this time frame is because of certain programs and processes that have been set up within the Champlain region and the Heart Institute that ensure that heart attack patients are treated quickly. The faster that we open up the blocked artery, the less damage that you'll have as a result of your heart attack. Factors that affect how quickly the healing process occurs and how quickly you get back to feeling like yourself again is often the size of the heart attack and other health problems that perhaps you had prior to admission to the Heart Institute. There is a physical, psychological, and emotional healing process after having experienced a heart attack. The physical healing requires you to limit or restrict certain activities for the next 6 to 8 weeks. For example, your doctor may ask you not to drive for 4 weeks from the day of your heart attack. More specific information related to physical activity after heart attack is discussed in our physical activity section starting on page 29 of your booklet and also in the physical activity section of our video. The psychological and emotional recovery can affect patients and their families quite differently. For some patients, this will be much more difficult than the physical recovery process. We understand that it is not easy to be told you have had a heart attack or you have coronary artery disease, requiring you to make significant lifestyle changes and take medication possibly for the rest of your life. The University of Ottawa Heart Institute Cardiac Rehabilitation Program can make a significant positive difference in all aspects of your recovery. Our multidisciplinary team, made up of doctors, nurses, physiotherapists, dietitians, counselors, and social workers, will help you and your family recover. And in many instances, patients have told us after completing the program that they have never felt better in a very long time. For more information on our cardiac rehabilitation program, please refer to page 57 in your guide. For questions or concerns during your recovery, please don't hesitate to contact our nursing coordinator at the indicated 24-hour number. This number is also indicated on the inside cover of your guide as well. Thank you, and we wish you all the best.